Hi, I'm Russell from VizRT Presales. I'm going to show you how to do a virtual run in Libero. So I've got my timeline here and I should choose where I want to do my virtual run. Now, the first thing you have to do with a virtual run is you must have a 3D frame. So what we can do is just hit detect. And now you can see that's a 3D frame instantly. And now, what I can do is to choose the player that I want to do the virtual run. So let's, for instance, let's select this. What you'll notice when I select virtual run here, it goes into auto jump. So now I'm going to select this player and you can see that I can now select the cutout. What I'm doing here is selecting where the player is running to so that I can then do the cutouts. So now I just right click and I go edit virtual run and it will fetch all those images and then it will perform all of the cutouts for that particular virtual run. And then in a minute I can check those cutouts, I can change them if I want to. So now the cutouts are all here and I can go through and scroll through and see if I want to change any of those or update them. But for the purpose of this, I'm going to just leave it as is. And you can see now that the on that pause, the virtual run is taking place at that position. So now I could, if I wanted to, just choose a different route for the player to run. So if you said, at this point, he should have actually been in this position. And you can just move that accordingly. And if you want to, you can just, it will snap back to its original position. But as you can see, I can move it as required. And there are various different versions of these. So you can have with the rewind, so you'll see it will play and then play back again. And then there's also strobe. So let's go back and see the strobe one. You can see it leaves a trail of the player. Strobe fade out, rewind, catch up. So there's lots of different modes of that. But that is how you do the virtual run.